So you learn a new guitar lick and you've been practicing it over and over and over, but it's still not making its way into your playing and coming out naturally. The reason for this is that you're practicing licks wrong. To find out how to fix it, stay tuned. Before we get into it, make sure you drop a thumbs up down below and also subscribe to the channel if you haven't already for more guitar lessons just like this. Most people practice guitar licks using the following process. Step 1, learn how to play the lick. Step 2, play it over and over and over and over. Step 3, hope that something good happens or it comes out in your playing. I know this doesn't work because I've gone through the exact same process, and most of the time the lick or piece of vocabulary doesn't end up making its way into my playing at all. And if it does make its way into my playing, it usually sounds really unnatural and forced. The key to practicing guitar licks the right way is to create your own variations on them and practice improvising variations. This is going to accomplish two things. Number one, you're going to be injecting your own musical personality into the mix here. You learned a lick from some other guitar player, but as soon as you start changing it and making variations, you are injecting your own musical self into that lick, and therefore you're actually not directly copying the lick. And number two, as a result of that, the vocabulary or lick is going to be integrated into your playing much more quickly, easily, and naturally. So how do we do this? Let's take this John Coltrane lick that I transcribed as an example. So to make some variations on the lick, what we want to do is find out what the concept is that the lick is based on. Now there's two parts to the lick. There's this first part, which is like a glissando. Just this kind of smooth motion between these two notes. And then we have all these other notes in between. And then we have this scale part in the second half. So the main part I want to extract from the lick is that glissando. So I'm going to use that concept now to improvise off of, and one thing I'm also going to do is change the notes. I'm not just going to use those exact same notes that are in the lick. I'm going to try using all the different notes that I can in the key. Practicing improvising with that concept that I took from the lick, that's where you're going to get the most value out of practicing licks. So besides practicing improvising, it's also a really good idea to write out your own variations, especially if this is something that's pretty new to you. So here's two simple ideas for writing some variations on any lick that you've learned. The first one is to change the ending of the lick. So again, the original lick went just like this. And now I'll vary the ending of the lick. Now, instead of changing the ending, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna add some notes before the lick would start. I could also just throw away that glissando part and change the first half of the lick and keep the second half of the original lick. So with all this stuff, especially the improvising, it really, really helps to know your fretboard super well, know every key across the fretboard, and know how the licks that you're learning fit into those keys. If you're looking for a step-by-step plan to do exactly that, get super comfortable and master the fretboard, master playing in any key all across the fretboard, check out jamsville.com and sign up for the Jamsville GPS Fretboard Fundamentals course. So if you learned something from this video and it helped you out, make sure you drop a comment down below. And if you have any questions, I'm really good about answering all my comments. Until next time, Listen, learn, and jam.